In this video, I explain hydraulic circuit designs. In this hydraulic circuit designs, the unidirectional motor is used, and this unidirectional motor is operated by using the 3x2 DCV. DCV means directional control valves. Okay, so I explain by using the animation so you can easily understand the how this system is work. So first we understand what is the symbol of unidirectional motors and what its meaning and what is the meaning of 3x2 DCV. So in this case, unidirectional motor can be operated by 3x2 directional control valves. Okay, so here you see how the unidirectional motor is drawn. Okay, unidirectional means that the motor is rotated only in a one directional. Okay, now this unidirectional motor is also called as the actuators. So there is a various type of actuator is there. So in a different hydraulic system, different type of actuator is used according to this requirement. But in this case, it is specifically given that is a unidirectional motor. Uni means the motor is rotated only in a one directional. Okay. Now inside this motor, the one triangle is provided and apex of the triangle is inside. Okay. And suppose that is a pump is there, then this apex is on the periphery of that. Okay. So when I show you this complete image, at that time you understand difference of the motor as well as the pump symbols. Now 3x2 DCV has a three ports. Okay, so first digit in any directional control valve is indicate the number of port, and the second digit it is the two. That two is indicate that is a two position is possible. Okay, now what is the name of the three port? The name, first name is the inlet port and it is denoted as the P. Second one is the tank port, it is denoted as the T, and the third one is the motor port A. Okay, in this case we use the motor, that's why I give the name motor port. If we use the cylinder, then we give the cylinder port A. Okay, and fourth port is there, then it is the motor port B. If in cylinder case, it is the cylinder port B. So here we need the two positions. Okay, so we need to draw the two square. So in a one square, there is a three port is there. Okay, so first we give the port P. From port P, two oil is supplied to the port A. Okay, so here you see that is a arrow is moving in upper direction, and the T port is the close. So this type of the symbol is indicate it is the close positions. Okay, for the second positions we need to draw second square. Inside this second square, another T port is there and the directional is also given. So here the A port. Okay, so in a second positions the hydraulic oil is flow from the A port to T port, and the P port is the close. Now it have the two positions, that is clear. Now we move towards the diagram and understand what is the first positions and second positions. So in a first positions of a spool of 3x2 DCV, oil under pressure flow from P to A and the T port is close. Okay, here you already see that oil is flow from P to A and the T port is the close, hence the shaft of the motor run. Okay, now we use the draw the complete diagrams. So every type of this hydraulic circuit we require to draw this part. Okay, so I show you this part together, and if you completely want to understand the general layout with the animations, then I provide the link in a card. Card means in the top right screen of your mobile you see the eye symbol. From that you can completely understand the general layout and in too easy way. So here you see this is the oil reservoir. This pipe does take the oil from the reservoir supplied to pump. Pump is increase the pressure of oil. So here the P port and another component, that is pressure gauge, pressure relief valve, and from the T port the oil is again supplied to the oil reservoirs. Now here we put this directional control valve, that is a 3x2. Okay, so it is a first position. So this first square is connected. So here you see oil is come from the P port, is go to the A port here. Okay, then after the pipe connection is there. By using this pipe connection, oil is supplied to the unidirectional motor. So here we draw the symbol of unidirectional motors. Okay, so it is not necessary to draw this triangle here. You can also able to draw this triangle at the any location, or you can also draw here. You also draw this bottom part, but taken care point is that apex is inside. Okay, now in a case of the pump, you see that apex is connected on the periphery. Okay, so this is the difference between pump symbols and the motor symbols. And here you see that the motor is rotated into the clockwise directions. So I hope you can understand the first positions. Now we move towards the second positions. Before moving on to second positions, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to oil hydraulics numerics as well as the another subject of mechanical engineerings. The various subject like refrigeration, air conditioning, IC engines, fluid power engineering, fluid mechanics, as well as the basic of mechanical engineering. Now we understand the second positions. For the second position, you see this diagram here. The most position is changed. Okay. So here the directional control valve is operated by using the different mechanism. So any one method is used to operate the directional control valve. That method I not draw here. But when the specific case is given, directional control valve is operated by using this method, then you need to draw the symbol here. Okay. Now in second position of the spool of 3/2 DCV, oil under the pressure flow from A to T. Okay. Why it is required A to T? Because we need to stop the motor. Okay. So when we stop the motor, so oil present inside this motor is supplied through this pipe, and this pipe to it is come into the A port, and from the A port here one pipe connection is there. So oil is supplied from port A to port T, and from the port T it is supplied to the tank through the filters. And here you see that the P port is closed. Okay, so here it is P port, and P port is closed, and hence the motor is stopped because we not supplied the oil to the motor, but we take the oil from the motors. Okay, so I hope you can also understand the second positions. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels, and don't forget to share with your friend.